And now, please welcome your host, Danny New.
Thank you. Thank you guys for coming. Wow. Welcome to the 150th episode of Off the Wire. The 150th, I know. Wow. You see, I had I liked this girl the whole year in English class. Her name was Michelle. She was a little out of my league, but she was like down to earth and very sweet. And here, you know, I'll show you a picture of Michelle. You'll understand. Look at her.
I'm ready to compete. I'm so glad you just invited me.
You look great on your own. Oh. You don't have any problems with me.
Wow. The fashion heroes are telling me this myself. This sounds perfect. 133 countries all over the world.
You're blushing.
Yeah, well, Brooke Hogan and Caroline just told me I'm pretty. I got to get back into serious mode now, you know what I'm saying?
Particularly since I'm not Jewish. You know, I'm honored.
Well, if you ever want to come join the tribe, let me know. We have jackets. And little hats.
I'm Lebanese. We may be related.
Yeah, you never know. What if we were related? Grandma, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, you know, you scared me a little bit. A lot of his jokes came from making fun of his first wife, and I haven't had my first wife.
I didn't really. You have a first wife?
No, I don't. I'm a young guy.
You can have mine.
Actually, I'm certain I've used the horn more on my car here than in the entire time I ever owned it. Everybody blows their horn here. I don't get it. What is that about?
Well, the thing is about here, and you'll get used to this, laws are just suggestions.
Like turn.
Signal Media, this is Dasha from Russia.
Dasha from Moscow, yes.
Yeah,
yes.
And they're going to show me their virtual reality for their animations, correct?
Yes.
Hello, everyone. It's me, Danny, reporting live from Russia. President Trump, is that you?
Wow. Okay. Oh, man. Isn't she great?
What are you gonna do?
So I can play Crazy Frog from the 80s. So it's like.
That's pretty rough. I don't know.
I thought I gave it my all, but. Particularly Shawnee Chasser, an ebullient, funkadelic grandmother who caught national attention this year for her battle to live outside in every fourth grader's dream house.
When I was a kid, I dreamed about Magic School Bus and Miss Frizzle and that little lizard thing, and now I'm literally walking into a place with a treehouse. Like, look at this.
So I'm clearly very excited about a treehouse here, but this story isn't just about this outdoor loft or how the county is actually trying to tear it down. It's firstly about Shawnee Chasser, the most hippiest, dippiest grandma you will ever meet.
You know, some people call themselves a tree hugger, but you sleep in a tree. All so right. What's your term that's like one above? How do you one up yourself with the tree hugger?
Well, I was a tree hugger. I started off as a tree hugger, and I ended up loving it so much, loving trees, that 25 years ago I said to my brother, I want to live in a treehouse.
Now, Shawnee is on her second treehouse. And of course, it's more than you think. You got to see this thing.
This is what I eat out of.
Is it a bowl made of coconut?
No, it's not coconut. It's calabash.
We're now going up to see the bedroom. She got a loft. Check this out. Oh, let me get
that's
that.
That's all right. That's
all right. Okay. Just have a little slumber party. So you don't get scared at all during, like, there are hurricanes down here, right? Like,
I won't stay in here in a hurricane, but my last treehouse, I don't know if you heard, but it lasted through Andrew, Wilma, and Katrina. It was the only thing standing, so they're made pretty good.
Clearly treehouses are safe. That's what I'm picking up.
That's what I'm thinking.
And of course, if you live in a tree, you'll get some other tenants, which I learned while interviewing her daughter, Ren.
Aw, he's totally hugging you. Oh my God, can I take a picture of you? Where, how do I do that?
I'm just gonna turn the camera around real quick.
Oh yeah, do that.
While I'm interviewing.
Yeah, we're best friends, but not everyone is Shawnee's. Miami-Dade County is now cracking down on her, let's say, unconventional home. They declined an interview, but emailed me their official statement saying these structures were found to be unsafe by the Unsafe Structures Panel, and that she may choose to hire a professional engineer. Now, why does she need an engineer? Well, Shawnee told me they're forcing her to pay tens of thousands of dollars to tear down the house part and rebuild it 7 feet from her neighbor's property line, which confuses her since she thought it was a safety issue. So to afford this, she has to both fundraise and continue to grow her business.
Okay, so now we're inside Shawnee's Green Thumb Popcorn Kitchen right now.
I'm gonna break this down for you. So Shawnee sells her own brand of organic popcorn at the Whole Foods down here, and she's got a whole crew and a whole kitchen, and they walk them through the whole process. So first, you pop it.
This will get you through half of Titanic.
Then you season it with stuff like cayenne pepper and onion powder, which apparently has an effect on me.
Don't put pepper. Okay, we're good.
That will have to shake it all up. And then you bag it, seal it, and it's good for the shelf. So now, Shawnee has to fundraise a whole lot of money. But she said she's not leaving this house regardless, because she has been defending this planet for way too long to leave her post now.
And I wanted to end with a quote by Martin Luther King, which says that our government defaulted in their promissory note to give citizens life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. I don't want them telling me what my happiness is anymore.
If they do come to take you to jail, do you have a plan for that?
I do. There's a song that I always sang as I was getting arrested for protesting.
Multiple times.
Multiple.
This is a routine.
Yeah,
okay.
This is what, the song.
I want to learn this song in case, while I'm here, I have to go to prison.
So. Okay.
You can forbid me everything. You can forbid me to think. You can forbid my tears to flow. And you can't stop this song that I sing.
All right, now
you did it.
Can,
let's go to jail.
Now you can chain yourself to the treehouse with me.
I'm not leaving this place.
If you're a Canes fan, last week was hard. Coming in as the highest ranked team in Florida for the first time since I had braces, and then to lose to Florida State in the final minutes, that's heartbreaking. However, the season's not over, and Miami looked to bounce back today at home against the Tar Heels. And new head coach Mark Richt looking for another strong first half like last week, but that was just not the case. Second quarter, UNC quarterback Mitch Trubisky finds Ryan Switzer in the end zone to make it 20-3 Tar Heels going into the half. Hey, don't count out the Canes just yet. Third quarter, running back Joe Yearby dives into the end zone to make this a two-possession game at 20-10. Miami would then tack down another field goal, but then on their last drive, quarterback Brad Kaya gets stripped, and that would seal it, folks. Another heartbreaking loss for the Hurricanes. Final score, 20-13 Tar Heels. South Floridians don't always care too much about hockey or really anything that requires sleeves, but this may be the year. Coming off an Atlantic Division title, the Panthers are gaining steam. Look to kick off another successful season tonight at home against the Devils. Now you see what I was talking about, that Atlantic Division title banner swaying proudly from the top of the BB&T Center. First period, Jonathan Marceau, the new recruit, slaps one so hard it bounces off a few defenders and into the net. Panthers up 1-0. But this would go to overtime. Michael Matheson makes an aggressive play on the board, sets up Alexander Barkov, and he flips it in. How about that? The Panthers win their first game in overtime fashion. Final score, 2-1. Meanwhile, in the Ontario Hockey League, check this out. A fan climbs over the glass, thinks he's found freedom, and then, bam, right on his bottom. But he gets right back up. But wait, why are you celebrating? What, that you made it a little further than Humpty Dumpty falling off the ledge? You know, you should probably get back on the ice right now. You probably have need to ice that thing. At least it's okay, though. I mean, look at that. That was nasty. Embarrassing. And that will do it for sports. Keith, back to you.